If you're overwhelmed at the amount of content there is on how to build muscle, you're not alone. I started working out about half a year ago, and although I'm very happy with the progress I've made so far, up until recently, I still had no clear understanding of how to train in a way that actually focuses on hypertrophy, which is the increase in size and number of muscle cells. There's a ton of contradicting advice on the internet about how to actually obtain a good physique, and everywhere you look, fitness influencers are trying to sell you their special workout plan, which guarantees to get you jacked in just a few months. It can be hard to sift through all of this and find out what you actually need to know. So I've put together a science-based guide on exactly what you have to do to train in a way that maximizes hypertrophy. Some of the stuff in here may surprise you. Okay, there are different ways to work out. Some people like to go to the gym. Some people like calisthenics. Other people... It doesn't matter what type of resistance training you do, you just have to make sure that it follows these key principles. First of all, you need to make sure you're following a training split where each muscle group is hit 2 to 3 times a week and there's at least 1 day of rest between each. And don't skip legs. If you don't know what a split is, it's basically the routine that determines what muscle groups you hit on what days. The 3 most common splits are the push-pull leg split, there's the upper-lower split, and there's the full body split. Which of these you choose mostly depends on how many days you're free to work out in a week. But I would advise if you have the option, go for the push-pull leg split because the other two lead to particularly long workout sessions. Which leads us to the next point, how long should workouts last? You should aim to limit your workouts to 1 hour. This is because longer workout sessions are associated with decreased effort and motivation, which means you only get diminishing returns past a certain point. After the 60-minute mark, cortisol and inflammatory markers actually reach unfavorable levels in your muscles in a way which isn't too great for you. And past 75 minutes, even testosterone production starts to go down. So, since we're limiting our workouts to 1 hour, we want to make them as time efficient as we can. You can do this by starting your sessions with a lot of compound movements, which work multiple muscle groups at once, before moving on to isolation exercises like bicep curls. And if you're following an upper-lower split or a full body split, you can also experiment with supersetting, which is where you alternate between exercises that work antagonistic muscle groups without resting. A key factor in building muscle is volume. If you want to effectively stimulate muscle growth, you have to get in between 12 and 30 sets per muscle group each week. And research has consistently found that performing more sets each week results in more muscle growth, regardless of whether you're new to training or if you've been training for a while. So, for example, if you're following a push-pull leg split, you're training each muscle twice a week, which means to get enough volume, you want to do between 6 and 15 sets each workout per muscle group. But you're not going to hit all of these sets using the exact same exercise. Instead, you're going to split them between 2 or 3. This is because of a well-documented phenomenon called regional hypertrophy, which basically means that different exercises can work different regions of the same muscle by stimulating different muscle fibers. So, the juicy part. How do we perform each exercise to stimulate as much hypertrophy as possible? Well, for this to make sense, we first need to talk about what actually makes muscles grow. You've probably heard that lifting weights puts tension on and damages the fibers of your muscles, which are then repaired or replaced during rest and regrow thicker, making your muscles bigger. Whilst it is true that mechanical tension is the primary driver of hypertrophy, there's a second very important factor which a lot of training plans don't take into account. And to effectively stimulate muscle growth, you have to trigger both. This second factor is called metabolic stress, which stimulates hypertrophy by triggering a number of anabolic signaling pathways. It's driven by the accumulation of metabolites in your muscle tissue, like lactate and protons, and muscle hypoxia, which is the absence of oxygen. It's now understood that to effectively stimulate hypertrophy, you have to train in a way that produces a high amount of metabolic stress while also producing enough mechanical tension. How do you do this? Well, firstly, for each exercise, you want to pick a weight that allows you to do between 6 and 12 reps for 3 to 6 sets. And this weight will likely fall between 60 and 80% of your 1 rep max. The reason you have to do at least 3 sets is because any less than this won't trigger enough metabolic stress to effectively stimulate growth. And any more than 6 sets will probably lead to overtraining. This also explains why you want to aim for between 6 and 12 reps. Doing just a few reps with a very heavy weight will put your muscles under a lot of mechanical tension, but it won't produce enough metabolic stress. And on the other hand, if you're doing a lot of reps, you're probably not using a weight that strains your muscle fibers enough. This range of between 6 and 12 reps has been found to be a sort of optimal compromise between the two, leading to the most hypertrophy possible. How do you know how many reps specifically to do within this range? Well, you want to make sure you're not training to failure each set. Although consistently training to failure does have hypertrophic benefits, there is evidence that it can lead to overtraining and psychological burnout. And there's also a study that shows training to failure causes reductions in resting IGF-1 concentrations, which is a hormone important for muscle growth. So I'd recommend stopping within one or two reps of failure for each set, but on the last set for each exercise, do as many reps as you can. This way, you're only training to failure occasionally, which is a safe way to slightly increase your gains. Over time, you're going to be able to start doing more and more reps with the same weight. But for your muscles to continue to grow, you have to keep challenging them. So you want to make sure that as you become stronger, you increase the weight accordingly so that you stay within the 6 to 12 rep range. A simple way to do this is to follow this rule. Each time you reach the point where you're able to do 11 or 12 reps every set for an exercise, you then increase the weight to one which you can only do 6 or 7 reps for each set. And you just repeat this cycle each time you need to. The final piece of the puzzle is making sure you consistently perform high effort quality reps. First, you want to make sure that you're using the correct form for each exercise in order to effectively stimulate each muscle growth and prevent injury. There are already thousands of videos on the internet explaining how to do every exercise imaginable with good form, so I won't get into that in this video. In addition to using good form, you want to make sure that the reps you are doing are controlled movements which eliminate momentum. I've found a good way to practice this is to pause slightly between the concentric and eccentric movements for each exercise. It's also important that you focus on isolating and contracting the specific muscle groups that an exercise is designed to work, because naturally your body will try and perform a movement doing the least work possible. That's pretty much everything you need to know in order to train in a way that maximizes hypertrophy. But it's important to remember that working out is just the process that triggers muscle growth, and most of your gains actually occur while you're asleep. So to make sure all your hard work in the gym doesn't go to waste, go and watch this video which I put together explaining exactly what you need to do to get the highest quality sleep possible. There's a lot more to it than just getting 8 hours a night.